A warm welcome to all. This is our first class after Onam holidays. Hope you enjoy your vacation. Today we are going to start lesson 5, separation of substances. Suppose you are given a basket full of mangoes and guavas and asked to separate them. Can you separate it? Yes, of course we can separate this guavas and mangoes by our hand. Imagine you are given a mixture of sand and salt and asked to separate them. Can you separate the salt and sugar by your hand? No, it is impossible. We cannot separate sand and salt by our hand. So, in this chapter, we are going to discuss different separation methods that we can use different situations. So, let us start our class. Fifth lesson, separation of substances. In our daily life, we are separating many substances from mixtures. First example, we are using strainer to separate tea leaves from tea. Here we are separating two components. The first one is tea and the second one is tea leaves. Tea is useful component and tea leaves is non-useful component. Tea we are drinking and this tea leaves, we don't eat tea leaves, we throw them away. So actually separating tea leaves from a liquid with the help of strainer. This one we are always using. The second one is churning or continuous stirring of curd. Actually this one we are doing, that is continuously stirring of curd to separate two components. The first component is butter and the second component is buttermilk. Makka means butter, lassi means buttermilk. Here butter is useful component and buttermilk is also useful component. So churning curd to get butter or buttermilk. We use both components. Both components are useful one. Third one is separation of grains from the stalk. This is grain, that is dried grains. We have to separate these grains from the dried stalk. Stalk means stem. Okay. So we are separating grains and stalks. Grains we eat as wheat grains. And stalks, we feed the straw to animals. That means it is used as animal feed. So both are useful components. So grain is separated from stalks of plant. And the next one is familiar for you. Separation of seeds from the cotton fiber. That is ginning. Already studied in third lesson. So here two components are the first one cotton fiber and the second one cotton seeds. Next is very interesting example for you. This is a vegetable salad. Number of vegetables are there, but some vegetables you don't like. Then what will you do? Yes, we have to separate the veggies you don't like and eat rest of them. So actually, we are separating non-tasty food from
tasty food. So now we have discussed many separation method, that is many examples we are doing in our daily life. Okay, then we are separating two or more components. Sometimes one component is useful and another component is not useful.
So can I ask one question?
Why do we separate substances? We have discussed many examples. So mainly three reasons are there. The first one, to separate harmful substances from a mixture. Harmful substances, for example, sometimes grains contains stones, insects, etc. These stones and insects are harmful one. So we have to separate that harmful substances from the mixture. And the second one, to separate non-useful substances from a mixture. For example, straining tea leaves from tea. Tea leaves are non-useful substances. Okay, tea is useful component. And the third one is, we also separate two useful components if we want to use them separately. That also we discuss, that is separating butter and buttermilk from curd. That means by the process of churning curd. These both components, that is buttermilk and butter, both are useful components. Okay, so these are the three important reasons for separating substances. In textbook, page number 36, you can see one table, table 5.1. Why do we separate substances? There you can see the first one, separate stones from rice. Why we are separating stones from rice? Second column, you can see the purpose. Why we are separating? Yes, these stones are impurities or harmful component. So, what is the purpose? To remove impurities or harmful components. Then, what we are doing with that impurities? That is the third column. We throw away the impurities. Okay. Then, the second one, churning curd to obtain butter. That also we have discussed. To separate two different but useful components. Which are the two different and useful components? One is butter and the second one is buttermilk. Both components are useful. Then what we are doing with that one? We use both the components. And third one, separate tea leaves. What is the purpose? To remove non-useful components. Here, useful component is tea and non-useful component is tea leaf. Then what we are doing? We throw away the solid component, that is tea leaves. We throw away the tea leaves and we use that tea. So here, different methods of separation we have to study in this chapter. So different methods are, the first one is hand picking and the second one is threshing and third one winnowing, sieving, sedimentation, decantation, filtration and evaporation. So these are the different methods of separation we have to study from this chapter.